light you in the dark. I show me the scary parts. I who are you when it's 3 a.m. and you're all alone? And LA doesn't feel like home.
It's your girl Roy Jules here today. Today we're gonna do something a little bit different because I want to switch up a little bit. You know, I've been switching up a little bit on my channel and giving different types of stuff. So a lot of different stuff are coming up. But today we're going to do shopping tips. And that's because a lot of people ask me on my Instagram, where do I get it? How do I shop? Some people can't even online shop because they either get it too big, too small, or basically it doesn't fit them. So we're just gonna speak on some shopping tips so it can help you guys a little bit more with your shopping and your unique styles and everything. So let's get this started. Don't forget to subscribe, give it a thumbs up, and don't forget to hit that notification button because, you know, it will tell you when I post videos. Okay, shopping tip number one is basically I think people should shop alone because, one, it's gonna be a little bit annoying and irritated if you find something and your friend doesn't find anything, and it's like, okay, I wanna go home. That person is rushing you to go home because they can't find certain stuff that they want, but you do. So it's best for you to go shopping by yourself so you can take your time, because shopping takes time. I believe shopping is like a sport because you really have to dig and you really have to look in your personal styles in different stores. So I think it's basically a sport. Next tip is basically organizing your shopping. What I mean by this is basically, if you go to a store, an in-store, you can check out their websites for in-store clothes and basically pattern an outfit with any objects that you want. So if you want a shirt, make sure you get a pants so you make it a whole entire outfit. Don't be going crazy like a lot of people that I know basically just go in the store and they buy it. And then they just go crazy because there's a lot of stuff around them. And it's like, they got a shirt, they got a dress, but they don't have pants for the shirt. They don't have shoes for the dress or a jacket for the dress. And then they go crazy and yeah, it's not a good picture. So what I do is basically I go online, I go to the online in-store clothes, and I just put a whole entire outfit together that I want to buy. So when I'm in the store, I get the items. Simple as that, and fast and efficient, and I don't have to really go crazy over anything. Next struggle is online shopping. So for online shopping, I've been online shopping for a while, and I have this technique that basically, some stores, it depends, I always read the reviews on the item that I'm getting, because sometimes the fabric could be a little bit tighter, but it's a size bigger. So basically, let's say if it's a 1X, it seems a little bit, you know, like an XL or an L, so I have to go up a size bigger. It's kind of a lot of mathematics. I also look at the size charts, and I also see the descriptions. So the descriptions will basically tell you percentage of stretchiness, what kind of fabric it is. So depending on the fabric, that I know polyester is a little bit more tighter than a regular one, but then stretchy. The most stretch is, I believe that I've seen, is 6%. So I'm like, okay, I will get this because this is what the size is. So basically, just check your size charts, check the reviews, and check the description to see if it's, you know, your body type. And if it is, you can get it. If it's not, then go ahead, because it could also say 6% stretchy, but it's really, really tight. Like, you really gotta know the store in order for you to actually do the online shopping, because returning is fucking hell. Like, online returning is hell, and I don't like online returning. I'd rather just give it to a friend and call it a day, or sell it on Depop. This tip, there's basically like different stuff, is thrift shopping. So thrift shopping is a way to not spend too much money, but then get vintage clothing, which I fucking love vintage clothing. Like, there's different types of thrift store clothing. There's the convenient one. So basically, the convenient one is you go, you know where everything is a certain price. Now, the next one is basically like your original Goodwills. Goodwill is everything is organized and everything is a certain price. Now, the other one, which I freaking love, is the one that has a cheap prices and everything is like literally organized, everything is donated, everything is secondhand. I love it because I can just go in there and just check everything out. They're very cheap, but my I think Goodwill, the Goodwill stores, my recommendation is to wash the clothes before you even wear it. Just wash it. Even though I know the store probably wash it before people donate and recommend people to wash it before people donate, but just to give that secure layer, wash it before you wear it. Just saying. But I love thrift shopping because one, the graphic vintage shirts are like amazing. They're very cheap. They're like range to $2. It depends, because I know one, the Goodwills in the city is a little bit more expensive than the ones I've seen in like Pennsylvania, New Jersey. They're a little bit more expensive, but the Goodwills are really good. I like going to see the vintage shirts, like everything vintage. I just love vintage. Thrift shopping is like basically the way to go if you want to save a little bit of a budget, but just not in the city of New York because that should be expensive as hell. Guys, this is my shopping little tips for you guys to, you know, improve a little bit of your shopping. And it took me a while to learn all of this by myself and do it, but I've gotten very, very, very good at shopping online, thrift shopping, and going to shop by myself, because I always used to like going shopping with other people, but then I would used to get pissed off because I used to get shit and they didn't get shit, and it's like, come on bro, be happy that I got something for me, like damn. But yeah guys, I hope you enjoyed. Take these tips if you want. If you don't, then I don't know what to tell you. Don't forget to go in the description below to go in my Instagram, Twitter, and Tumblr. Don't forget to hit one of these icons because it's probably my previous and last video, so you can check it out. And yeah, if you like this video, give it a thumbs up, subscribe, hit the notification button, and I'll see you guys next time. Bye.